Katuna Border had faced stagnation in business for nearly 4 years since its closure in February 2019 due to diplomatic tensions between Uganda and Rwanda. At the time of closure, Rwandan President Paul Kagame accused Ugandan authorities of spying, abducting Rwandan citizens, and hosting dissent against the Kigali administration. In response, Rwanda issued travel advisories cautioning its nationals against traveling to Uganda, citing safety concerns. On June 22, 2022, Rwandan nationals were finally permitted to cross freely into Uganda for trade, leading to a noticeable surge in revenue on the Ugandan side. In a phone interview, Edrin Mutebi, the Acting Assistant Commissioner of Public and Corporate Affairs at Uganda Revenue Authority, revealed the significant impact of the border's closure and subsequent reopening on revenue collection. He stated that when the border closed in 2019, revenue collection exceeded 1 billion Uganda shillings. Upon reopening in 2022, revenue soared to over 2.7 billion Uganda shillings, indicating a substantial recovery of previously lost revenue.
Now, this shows you the strategic importance of this border post between the countries that are using it mostly, that is Uganda, Rwanda, and Burundi, because it's a transit route. So its closure definitely will have to agree that it had an impact in terms of revenue collection, because if you look at how much we collected in 2020 when the border was closed, and I think these were just two things, it was the reduction was about 98% of the total collection before closure. So when you look at the current statistics showing us a 42% increment in terms of revenue when the border is fully operational, by 2023 we observe an increment of revenue from 2.7 to 3.8 billion.
Mutebi emphasized the strategic importance of the border, especially for countries utilizing it for trade. He expressed optimism about the future, foreseeing positive outcomes in trade and collaborative efforts between Uganda and Rwanda.
This shows you how strategic this border post is, and it also gives us a picture of the impact of the closure and how now government is benefiting from the cooperation between the two countries in terms of facilitating trade among these countries that are using this border post. By simply looking at the data, if I collected 2.7 billion and I'm also seeing now in 2023 I'm seeing 3.8 billion, already the trade is giving us a positive trend. And as long as we continue the cooperation between countries in terms of committing to facilitating trade among ourselves, then we are seeing a positive trend in terms of revenue collection from that border post.
Christmas Biarugaba, the town clerk of Katuna Town Council, highlighted the positive impact on local revenue, stating that collections had surged between 40% to 45% since the free movement of Rwandan nationals into Ugandan markets.
Now, before we used even to collect 0.5% revenue, but now we are approaching 40% now, 40-45%. So we are wishing, really, we are convinced that by next year, really, we shall collect more than we have been using.
Biarugaba also celebrated the increased purchase of maize flour, a staple commodity from Ugandan markets, by Rwandan nationals, considering it a significant achievement.
Contributing, really, something, yeah, because it is also part of the business in Katuna. Posho is also part of business in Katuna. And of course it is contributing some, because the Rwandese, they used it to come and buy posho from here. So now it is now helping us to collect some revenues compared to last time.
Local traders Bosco Ainamani and Julius Karagwa echoed the sentiment of improved trade conditions since the reopening, expressing hope for continued progress. Business at the border is improving because we get Rwandans are able to come and buy from us. We are really happy because Rwanda fully opened its borders. Businesses are now seriously thriving. As the border reinvigorates trade activities, the collaboration between the two nations appears to be on a positive trajectory, fostering economic growth and stability in the region. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.